Bhishma's vow. On the banks of the river Yamuna lived a community of fisher folk. Their ruler was known as Dhivar Raj. Once he found a girl child in the river and took her home to raise her as his own daughter. He named her Satyavati, but the strong odor of fish emanating from her body led her to be called Matsagandha. When Satyavati reached teenage, she used to ferry people across the Yamuna in a boat free of charge. On one particular day, the stars foretold a different fortune for the young girl. The great sage Maharshi Parashar boarded Satyavati's boat that afternoon. The rishi saw that the girl bore signs of becoming the mother of a very great soul. He told Satyavati what the gods had ordained and gave birth to a divine son through her. This boy later became the great Bhagwan Vedavyas and was renowned throughout the three worlds for his austerity, penance and supreme knowledge. Shantanu meanwhile had still not gotten over his yearning for Ganga and used to wander the forest. On one such occasion, he glimpsed Satyavati and was smitten by her. He approached her saying, "O beautiful one, you seem to be a damsel of divine birth. Will you marry me?" "O king, I am the daughter of Dhivar Raj, the ruler of the fisher folk. You must approach my father in this regard." Shantanu approached Dhivar Raj, asking for Satyavati's hand. But he put forth one condition. He said, "Only if you agree to make Satyavati's son the king of Hastinapur after you, will I agree to fulfill your demand." Shantanu was stunned. How could Shantanu even think of depriving his son Devavrat of his natural right? The king returned dejected, but he could not banish Satyavati from his heart. Devavrat did not fail to notice his father's mental condition. When he came to know of the real reason, he took a few ministers and set out from Hastinapur to the banks of the Yamuna and met Dhivar Raj. "With due respect," the prince said, "on behalf of my father, I have come to ask for your daughter's hand." "O prince, I have no objection whatsoever, but my condition stands that my grandson alone must become the king." Devavrat replied calmly but firmly, "Rest assured, in the presence of all those Kaurava leaders, I promise that I have forsaken my right to the throne of Hastinapur from this very instant. Your daughter's son alone shall be the future king." Everyone was shocked into silence. But Satyavati's father was not easily convinced. He said, "O prince, you are truly a great soul to forsake such power without a second thought. I have no doubt that you shall live up to the promise. But if your sons refuse to respect your promise, this will lead to conflict in the family. What is the guarantee that this shall not happen?" When Devavrat heard these words, he stood up and addressed Satyavati's father. "Listen, Dhivar Raj, I shall set at rest all your doubts and anxieties once and for all. I shall also fulfill my father's wishes, holding my mother, the divine Janhavi, who flows through the three worlds as witness, holding all the devas, the goddesses, the five elements, Gandharvas, Apsaras, the Mother Earth, the rivers and the mountains, the sun, the moon and the stars, all these venerable elders worthy of worship as witness. I, Devavrat, the son of King Shantanu and Ganga, do solemnly swear that I shall be a celibate as long as I live on this earth. The mountains may leave their place and the oceans may dry up, but I shall never swear from my oaths." Terrifying thunder and lightning erupted as soon as Prince Devavrat uttered these words. The earth shook and the heavens gasped. The gods from the heavens showered flowers on Devavrat and spoke in one voice, "Bhishma, Bhishma, this one is Bhishma." Bhishma turned to Satyavati and said, "Mother, let's proceed to our home." Shantanu was proud when he heard of his son's great sacrifice and blessed him saying, "Son, what you have done for me today has never been done by any son for his father before. I gave you a boon whereby you will die as per your wish only. Father, I consider it my supreme duty to be the guardian and protector of our Kuru dynasty and Hastinapur. I shall leave no stone unturned to ensure that Hastinapur is not only safe and secure, but also becomes the most powerful empire. Till such time, I shall not even think of departing from this world." Thus, Devavrat came to be known to this world as Bhishma.